So, I don't know if you know this, but horror movies are my shtick. They're so good, I decided to do something fun for Spooky Month. A top 10. That's right. Today we'll be ranking my top 10 favorite horror movies of all time. Now, this will be ranked based on A, how scary it is, and B, how good it is. So, as Schaeferillo says, let's get her ranked. At least that's what I think he says. I don't know.
This.
The Exorcist is quite an interesting movie, as I didn't really find it scary. Nah, what was scary was the face. Pinnacle of jump scare. But overall, I thought it was more good than scary. And that's okay. I like the demon Pazuzu and how evil and nasty he can be. But besides that, I think there are nine more movies greater to go.
Talk dirty to me.
Now, Talk to Me is also an interesting film, considering the fact that everyone was saying that this was the scariest film ever. But to be honest, I didn't really find it that scary. There was only one part I found scary, and that was Riley brutalizing himself. Yeah, I don't really have much to say about this movie, but I think it's overall a fun blast. Okay, the scary thing about The Conjuring is that it's allegedly real, but I'm gonna be honest for a minute. Why did they make Annabelle so damn scary? In real life, she's a Raggedy Ann doll, but in this movie, she's like a glass-made doll, with creepy eyes and the face. God! But overall, I didn't really find the human characters that compelling, to be honest. I mean, sure, I like them, but the demons really steal the show.
I fucking hate clowns.
Now we get on to the really scary movies, and Art the Clown is downright terrifying!
Get it?
He's more terrifying than the Joker and Pennywise if they had an unholy baby, but I digress. By the way, this movie is really gory, so don't watch this if you're easily sick. Like The Conjuring, however, the main girls are pretty bland, but it's all right since it's Art the Clown's show.
My mom gets my clothes for me at Hot Topic. I dress like a Nazi. I'm pissed all the time.
Clive Barker is an interesting fellow, as he was responsible for creating Candyman and this movie, Hellraiser. Yeah, this movie is also pretty gory, so I don't blame you if you miss out. But overall, the characters were good. I like Pinhead, I like Christy, but I can't stand the uncle. He's just disturbing. But my favorite line from the movie does come from him.
Jesus wept.
Yep, pretty scary.
What the hell was that for?
You hurt my feelings.
This movie, oh boy. Saw is great from its score, especially its main theme, Hello Zep, and the twist. Oh, the twist is something else. I won't spoil it, even though it came out 20 years ago. Surprisingly, too, this movie is not that gory, as its later sequels become more gory. Oh well, still recommend it though.
I'm going to fly for you.
Final Destination is my shit. But if I had to choose out of all of them, it would be Final Destination 5. By the way, this movie is also gory, but anyways, I find this movie great due to the fact that it has a really strong cast. Tony Todd has always been amazing, but I couldn't say the same for the rest of the cast. But in this movie, everyone is great. Except the perv. And when something bad is about to happen, you actually feel for the characters. For those who don't know, Final Destination is about a man who sees into the future of how him and certain people will die. He avoids this and the other people's deaths, only for death to come back and claim his lives. This movie is that good.
What the hell?
Now, Child's Play, or all the Chucky films for that matter, aren't really that scary, but if I had to choose one, it would be the first Child's Play. This movie is great from its actors to the main doll himself.
Hi, I'm Chucky, wanna play?
Ah! This movie is actually pretty scary on first watching. Chucky is my favorite horror movie character of all time. And Andy Barclay, he's so adorable.
Wait, that's the wrong Andy?
But yeah, Brad Dourif as Chucky and Alex Vincent as Andy really steal the show. And I love it. And yeah, it's not as scary as the other films. But at least it's not like its sequels. I mean, come on.
What the hell?
Candyman. The man, the myth, the legend. Truly, nothing is more terrifying than a supernatural beekeeper with a hook for a hand that splits you from your groin to your gut. And once you find out Candyman's backstory, God, it's horrific. And honestly, you kind of feel bad for the guy. Once an artist that fell in love with one of his clients only to be hunted down by the girl's father, and then the rest of the Cabrini Green residents, they tie him down, slice his hand off, smear him with honey so bees could sting him to death. It's truly horrifying. And now he's stuck as a demon in the mirror world forever. But this is not the last horror movie we have for this countdown. Pet Sematary is a film like no other. This story was said to be so dark that even Stephen King was worried about putting the story up. This movie, from its soundtrack to its characters, is truly horrifying. This is a story about how a family loses their baby boy in a horrific accident, but this time, they have the chance to bring him back from the dead. I have a dog, and I love her very much. If something bad happened to her, which resulted in her dying, I wouldn't know what to do. And so I would kind of go through the desperate lengths of what Lewis did for Gage. This movie is horrifying, and it's not for everyone, but that's why it is my number one pick for my favorite scary movie.
No!